vlog, I'm going to take you through the start to finish of our dress design. This vlog's going to go over maybe a month or two, so we're going to take a little while to piece it together. But this is the first day that I've sat down and I'm going to start walking through and pulling together all my ideas about what I want for my next dress. So I wanted to walk you through exactly what I think about and the considerations I make when I'm designing my new gown. So before I get started on my dress design, the first thing I do is jot down the key features that I am liking in the dresses that I'm seeing at the moment. So I've been especially inspired by the international championships. I've just come home from there and I'm feeling really inspired. Having seen heaps of dresses, both Latin and ballroom, they both tend to inspire me. So I've written down a couple of things that I might consider putting in this next dress. The first thing is 3D stones. Now these are really cool feature. I hadn't ever seen them until I started working with RP Atelier, and they use them. They're basically just like 3D crystals, and they kind of sit and stand off your dress. I'll try and put in a photo on screen of some of the designs that RP has made in the past and used those stones. Very effective and I think really, really impressive. Now I spoke to the owner and designer of RP and Agnieszka, and she said that they have only three colors in stock at the moment, and that's the crystal, light topaz and gray. I think she also said she had black as well. I have to check that, but they're their key colors. So that's something to keep in mind when I'm picking a color. So the second feature I have written down are sheer cutouts. Now, I think Latin dancers use these a lot, and I think they can be super effective and have a really sexy look. And that's something that maybe I'm considering putting in my dresses. So it's using the stretch net in one section of the dress, most likely on the body to get that really cool sheer effect. The next one are short bugle fringe. I think they've become quite popular recently on ballroom dresses. They're obviously always quite effective on Latin dresses and haven't been used too much in the past on ballroom dresses, but now they're kind of coming in and I really like the effect. So maybe a feature somewhere on the dress, on the back, on the front, that has just some short bugle beads or some type of fringing. I like that look, it's really cool. The next one I've jotted down is lower back decoration. And I think that to me is more making a feature of the back of the dress. So when you're in ballroom hold, obviously the back of the dress is really important to have a really nice effect while you're dancing, because the front is covered by your man. So just keeping that in mind, I think I really want to make sure that the back, especially the lower back, is a feature on this next dress. And then the last one is the one sleeve feature. Now I've seen this many times, but I saw it at Internationals on Monica and it looked fantastic. And I think that's a really, really, really cool look, especially to kind of follow the line of the arm and then to have one free arm of the dress. So let's see if we can incorporate those in our dress design. So the next thing to consider are our colors. I have a little color chart here and this is what I use to determine what I'm going to use. So I've just had a red dress, so that's straight away I can knock off these colors. These are not the colors that I'm going to be able to use for my next dress. Pink again is a very similar color to red, so it's probably something that I won't consider. Purple is quite different, so I could possibly use these colors. In terms of blue, I have had a blue dress not too recently, maybe a couple of years ago, but it does still seem fairly recent for me. It was this turquoise color, so I would probably consider
having maybe more of these greeny blue colors rather than the turquoise or the bluebell. In terms of dark colors, the midnight blue, the midnight sky, the blueberry, and black hematite, those type of colors. I personally love those colors, but I also have to think about the resale of the dress, and a lot of people like bright dresses on the floor, which is understandable. You want to get the most effect on your dress. You want to have the most eyes on you on the floor. And so a lot of people love those bright colors. And so I think I really have to kind of step away from anything that's a little bit darker. As classic and as beautiful as it can look, I do have to think about the resale of my dress. And other colors like cappuccino, I think that is a beautiful color. It can look, it's that kind of coffee, coffee browny, coppery color. But unfortunately, again, it's maybe a bit too unique and something that wouldn't sell quite as easily. So with that in mind, I think we can really look at this half of the color palette. So we're looking at our greens and our yellows. I think that's, and maybe some purples. I think that's where we're at the moment. So keeping in mind that I really want to use those 3D stones, I have to try to pick something that's going to work with crystal, either crystal light topaz or gray. So light topaz is that in that yellowy palette, so we could definitely use one of these, probably one of the lighter ones, like sassy yellow. So and I think that would be a really nice color. I haven't had a yellow dress dancing with Jonathan, so that could be very, very effective. I think it looks nice on blondes as well. The other one is crystal. So crystal AB can just go with any, really any colored dress. So that kind of leaves it more option. And the gray, I don't know if I would use that with these colors that I'm looking at the moment. Definitely I could use some crystal colors, colored 3D stones with the lilac color. So maybe that's something to consider. All right, let's go up and start doing some drawing, getting my ideas on paper. I'll show you some of my other designs that I've done in the past. Don't think I'm the best drawer ever. I'm a better dancer than I am a drawer, I have to say. But these are the designs that I have drawn in the past. And maybe you'll recognize some of the drawings. So this was my white and gray dress. Really, really broad shoulders on this drawing. A really, really skinny waist on this one. So I'm not the best drawer, but it's really just to give the designer the idea. So I had the white ostrich feathers, I had the silver body underneath, and then the white lace motifs on top. So that's one of them. This is another one that I drew. I don't think this one ever came into, ever actually went into a dress design that I made, but that was, I think that was probably around the same time as I was considering this one. So you can see how that evolved into this dress. And again, I think this is a very similar one, again, with the motifs. So I drew a few designs just to really get an idea of where I want to take the dress, and coming up with the final dress is usually after quite a few drawings. Finished drawing the design. I've actually drawn it in two colors just to get an idea of what looks and feels better. So if you come in for a close-up,
You can see that here I've incorporated that one sleeve idea. So this sleeve will be fully covered in a stretch net, and then you can see that will kind of link into the back. So a nice big deep back, which incorporates both the sheer cutouts that I really like and the one sleeve design. Then I'm also hoping to maybe use some crystal stones here. And so we can have those 3D crystal stones here and maybe up around the bodice there. And then I'm thinking some kind of fading and again using that big float with a couple of bugle beads hanging off the arms. So I've now drawn that up in both the yellow and the purple. The yellow will probably use those light topaz 3D stones that Agnieszka said that they had. And on the purpley pink design, we might use the crystal AB stones, which can be very striking as well to have just one color and then the really striking crystal stones. So yeah, I know I mentioned earlier that I was thinking about doing the lilac, but drawing it in the colored pencils really gave me a feel for what it would look like in like a darker purple, and I think that's quite nice. And so I found this fuchsia pink color. Maybe that will be the way we go. So I'm going to now send these three designs to the RP Atelier team, and I'm going to ask them what they think will work and if it will look good. I think the one I'm most unsure about whether it will work or not is this jade and black one. I'm not too sure what it's going to be like incorporating the two colors, especially with that faded skirt. So I'm going to really rely on them to tell me whether they think it'll work or not. I think these two, this design in either color, will look really, really nice. But yeah, I want something really effective. This is gonna be a really special dress for us. So I'm looking forward to it. Let's see what they say. I wanted to update you on how I went with the design. I sent through both of my final drawings to RP Atelier, and Agnieszka has come back with some comments. And we've basically decided to go ahead with the one sleeved dress. So I love that idea, and we are going ahead with the yellow color. Agnieszka thinks that is going to be the most striking color on the floor, and I agree. I haven't had a yellow dress for quite some time now. I had a youth Latin dress back in the day. It was all bugle beads, and I had long black gloves with it. My mum actually made it, and it was stunning. I loved it, so I can't wait to see and feel what this one's like to wear. So I'll show you the drawing that she did for me. It's basically a version of the drawing that is a little better done than mine. She's obviously much more skilled in this area than me. So you can see here, she's got all the details there. Some of the details that I missed, I obviously missed putting in a zip. So that's kind of crucial to the design. So we're gonna be putting in a zip in the side so it's easy to get in and out of. And she basically has just detailed everything here. So we're going to be using yellow stones across it and have those big chunky silver crystals. So I think it will be really unusual, and I haven't really seen those big crystals used so much, so I can't wait to see how it comes out. Her team work so quickly. It's gonna take her less than 4 weeks from the design that we discussed previously to basically getting the fabrics, creating it, and posting it from Poland to Australia. So I'm really excited about this dress. I think it's gonna come out really, really well. I can't wait to see what she comes up with, and I will be sharing it with you. Stay tuned, it'll be coming in a few moments for you guys. I have been waiting for this package and cannot wait to open it. We've just come back from a style, so it was perfect timing. It is my new dress, so let's open it. stones I was talking about. So these are the 3D stones. Wow, they look even more spectacular than in the photos. That is just beautiful. Wow. I will have to try it on to show you guys. That is just absolutely gorgeous. It needs a bit of a steam. Obviously, it's been in a box, but is that not just spectacular? We've got some spare stones. So these are the stones that we use, the crystals, and the arm piece. That is just beautiful. Oh, so happy. Let's try it on. So this is the dress. This is the finished product, guys. So I received the dress a few days ago and we decided that we would add a couple more stones just to really make these silver crystals pop, and I think that has kind of just added the finishing touch to what was already a stunning dress. I definitely could have left it, but I just decided to make it that little bit extra bit special, just because this is our first professional comp and our national championships. So I think this dress is just absolutely stunning. It is everything that I envisioned for the dress, everything that we discussed through the design process. I hope you can now see how much it's come to life. I think the back is probably my most favorite part of the dress, the cut of it and the way that she's added these beautiful big stones. And again, as always, RP Atelier always do the most beautiful skirt, so you can see that it really has the most beautiful movement. It's very, very elegant, and it will accentuate the lines and the movement that we're going to have in our dancing. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. It was something that's kind of taken place over a few months. So only 2 months. We started the design process at the start of November, and we've basically come to this point now, being the start of December. So, 4 weeks is a pretty quick turnaround time, but that's how the RP team work, and they're just incredible at what they do. I feel so lucky to be able to work with Agnieszka and her team at RP Atelier. I thoroughly enjoy taking on this process. If you have any questions about any element within what we've done in this video, please check it in the comments. I cannot wait to wear this dress at the Australian Championships in a few days' time. I think I will feel absolutely stunning, and this is just going to be another one of those special dresses. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, please do to hit that like button and subscribe, and we will have an Australians video coming to you soon, where you can see me dancing in this dress. Thanks a lot, guys. Bye.